You gotta be careful nowadays anyway, man. That whole sex thing is out of hand. Especially if you're dating. If you're still dating, be careful. But it's always old sexy honey with the kids that wanna get you. Serious. It's always an old fine ass, like around 30-year-old, that she got a kid or something, but you gotta make sure that you let her know the rules are off the top. Don't be thinking you're gonna be instant daddy trying to be goody two shoe motherfucker. Yeah, I take little Reddy to school. Fucker, you a bachelor. You don't know shit about dropping kids off at school. You got the nigga all down the street. He don't know where the fuck he at. Shit, I was dating a honey like that. She had little kids. She goes, can you take him to school? I'm like, what? All right, I mean, I'll help you out, but I'm gonna tell you right off the top, I'm a bachelor. I get him to the spot, though. We get up there, I'm like, Gurt! All right, what time you get off, out, done, little motherfucker? What? Whatever y'all call it. I'm gonna be right here. I'm gonna blow one time, and I'm hitting the block. Be out here. Shit, gone across the street. You a man, cross the street. Shit. Look both ways. You be all right. I don't feel like turning around. Go ahead. Shit. I ain't the one, man. Because there's some honeys, they try to use reverse psychology. Well, if you want to date me, you got to like my son, too, because he got the... Hey. Be reading me no rules off the top. I ain't your little kid. Shit. I tell you whether I'm going to kick it with you and your son or not. Fucking trying to act like you doing me a favor by letting... Oh, you got to kick it with me. We going to Chuck E. Cheese, then you got to take us to... Like, if you get attached to the kid, you ain't going to break up with her ass. Like, shit. You and this little motherfucker both be on the couch missing me. Fuck that. Trying to run no house rules on a motherfucker. You better wait till we get tight first. You better wait till you get some leverage. You better at least wait till I get hooked on the booty or something. Shit. Serious, because the ones that try to come right off the top want to introduce you to their kid first. Y'all ain't even went out yet. Yeah, come over here and pick me up. You get over there, she's bringing the car seat out. Like, hey, hold up, where we going? I got a son and he come everywhere I go, buckle that in. And all of a sudden you riding down the street like, how the fuck this happened? You looking in the rear view, this little nigga head all in the way and shit. You like, I don't even know this fool's name. What's his name again? Little Reggie. Damn. He throwing shit at the back of your head while you drive. You better quit playing. Little Reggie, you better, all right, is he retarded? Is something wrong with him? Something wrong with him? I ain't the one. He cussing and throwing shit at you. He got Tourette's, right? He got Tourette's? You better tell me, because he ain't right. Something ain't right. No, ain't no, it ain't like he's special. Everybody don't ride with no helmet at 2 years old. He ain't special. Something ain't right. You lying to me. Shit. Then you get the other honeys that want to play the opposite for you. They got their game plan all worked out. They want to get you hooked on the booty first, then introduce you to the kid. Like, oh, I got you now. You already in love with me now. You ain't going nowhere. Even if I got a big 7-foot retarded 2-year-old, you ain't going nowhere. Shit. Them the ones you got to watch. You be over there. Every time you go over there, it's just y'all kicking it. Everything lovely. Bunch of toys piled up in the corner. Ain't never nobody playing with them. You like, damn, baby, who play with this? See, I mean, he ain't never here. Who's this? Oh, nobody. Motherfucker, 2 years old. What, he got a license or something? He always out kicking it. He ain't never home. Finally, that one day, she decided it's time to put you off the hook. She going to be in there, y'all on the couch, about to get naked like you usually do on Thursday night. We can't. Lil' Junebug is here. Who the fuck is Lil' Junebug? That's my son. I told you about him 4 months ago. Well, I ain't seen him. I thought he left. Shit. Thought you were just saying you like to have a little Junebug. I didn't say he was already here. He comes stumbling out the kitchen with a pair of scissors in his hand. Trying to stab you while you're sitting on the couch and shit. It's always the badass little kid, too. Can't never be the well-behaved little cat with the fine-ass mama with the good booty. It's either a sexy mama with the good booty, badass retarded son, or it's the okay-looking broad that's a real good friend and you could grow to like her with the well-behaved sweet kid. Like, damn, I'm in a dilemma. Shit. And lying, cause some kids got sex radar too. Some kids, soon as they mama get butt naked, they gonna interrupt like a motherfucker. They just born to intervene. They don't want nobody on their mama's ass. Damn, man, them the ones you gotta watch. I dated a honey like that. She didn't never want to lock her door. 2-year-old daughter, right down the hall. Never want to lock the door. I'm like, all right, I'm gonna tell you what, one of these nights I'm gonna be feeling it and I ain't gonna stop. She gonna get a show, okay? She gonna straight up get a show. I'm gonna tell you right off the top. You know, I done helped raise 8 nephews. I know about kids, trust me. That was that one night. We in there, as soon as you get the zipper to get, bzzz, mama! She all up at the edge of the bed. Wait, what y'all doing, huh? Who this man with his booty out? What was this? Like, damn. You gotta be careful. Ain't enough room for both of us in here. You're gonna have to do something about this. So that one night when you feel like, okay, tonight is the night. You know, some nights you be feeling it. You're like, oh, it's going down tonight. I'm gonna beat that ass up like the school bully. You know, it's one of them nights where you feeling kind of good. So we get to the house, man. She gonna put that little crack in the bedroom door. As soon as she went in the bathroom, I just clack, 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 clack. Locked it. Took all my clothes off, just waiting to ambush her ass. I'm hiding behind the bed, just waiting, butt naked. It's some old Desert Storm shit. I got face paint on. I done went all out. I'm crazy. As soon as she come out, I just jump on her back. It's on. As soon as I get it in, all of a sudden, hear them little feet coming down the hallway. She hit that door. Mama, boom, boom. Yeah! Yeah! She trying to go like, she be all right. Come on, she be all right. Wait. She gonna be all right. Come on. She ain't crying. That was her feet. That was her feet. Come on now. There ain't nothing worse than stopping some good sex right in the middle. We cannot do that. Women, y'all can stop and start. We on a one-track mission. We figure like, once you start, ain't no timeouts, nothing. You can't stop for nothing but death. Women be like, wait a minute, I gotta use the bathroom. Yeah, too late for all that. I got a bucket right here by the bed, come on. Cause men be like, if we let them get up, they might change their mind. Serious, man. And don't be ashamed if you done bought some fake titties, God bless you, show that shit. You know, that's like buying a new car, keeping it in the garage, let it out. You knew when you was getting the shit done, you wanted somebody to notice. If don't nobody say shit, then you gonna be mad. Yet you gonna try to walk around like you ain't noticed you had your titties done. Like, hey, Linda was a 22B on Thursday. Now she a 34F, goddamn. Linda, did you do something? I just been working out. Bullshit, Linda. I've been looking at your titties in this office for 4 years. They ain't never looked that damn good. Come on, Linda, let me look at them. Come on. Just take one out. Let me see the nipple. Let me see how I did for you. Yeah, you trying to get technical. Let me see. Did he go through the navel or through the titty? Like you all interested. Really? Let me see. Did he go through? Did he leave a scar? Let me see. Like you were a buddy all of a sudden. I ain't lying. I ain't one of them motherfuckers to lick a gift horse in the mouth. You could have a price tag still swinging on the motherfuckers for all I care. I still test them out for you. Shit. I got my degree in medical technology, so I know some anatomy type shit. Let me see you with your new titties. Like, you know you're supposed to palpitate them every day to get them loose, right? Let me help you out. See, you wanna really grip them. You wanna get up in there, see? You be all in the break room squeezing your coworker's titties. Yeah, I'm just helping her out. She just got these. And the next day you start getting more into it. Yeah, you want to lick them every Thursday too. By the end of the week, you in there with a video camera. Yeah, you want to, yeah, do that. Yeah. You're all on the table in the break room getting freaky with it. Damn. But that's okay though, women. Don't be scared to get freaky. It's your world. You can get freaky if you want to. Ain't no law against it. You need to be able to get loose every now and then. It ain't just the men. Plus, women freakier than men when they comfortable. That's the thing they don't want you to know. See, I'm observant. I'm observant. It's, you don't find out, especially depending on how long you've been dating them. They don't want you to think they're a freak right off the bat. So they try to lay low and hide the freakiness. So you gotta let them come out with it on their own to make it look like they surprising you, but you didn't know. I ain't 100% for no reason. I be thinking. So you gotta watch yourself, man, because it's one of them nights like tonight. Your girl have a couple of drinks. She go home feeling lovely. Yo ass feeling kind of average. She throw you down and screw you like a runaway slave. I ain't lying. You be laying on the bottom like a punk getting raped. Like, hey, baby, wait a minute. Wait a minute. I gotta work in the morning. Hey, get off me. This ain't right. What you doing? Get off me. You done lost your mind. I don't know who you think I am. I mean, dang. Give me my drawers. I go to church. I'm insulted and embarrassed about what just happened. But I'm gonna call you tomorrow. I'll probably be better able to deal with it by then. I just wasn't ready tonight. I'd have wore my new drawers if I knew we was gonna get down. You know, cause when a woman get extra freaky, that be making men nervous, cause we be thinking, oh shit, she might know some shit I don't know. That's scary to us. We wanna be the one doing all the freaky shit. Like, if you ever go to a woman's house and she pull out a dildo and hand it to you, don't look stupid like you ain't never seen one. What the hell you want me to do with this? What the hell? Why you got this in your drawer? Who gave you this? I want to know the man's name. Like she just handed you a bomb or some shit. What you want me to do with this? Ain't no reason for you to have this. You turn into a slave. This is not going to help nobody. You got to play it off like you cool with it so she don't feel self-conscious. Because as soon as you give her that crazy look like, are you a hoe? You just fucked it up for yourself. Because then she going to snatch it back and go, nah, I was just playing. That ain't even mine. That's my girlfriend. She left it over here. Okay, I'm going to just lay down and do what you going to do. See, you could have had the Moulin Rouge. You done fucked up. You done fucked up and got you the striptease instead. Don't get it twisted. Serious, man. You got to relax. Damn.